We got hit California House Country on telly.
I would have done some Boston Curl.
Hey guys, welcome back. We've brought a special guest.
The little fella.
The Rose Between Two Thorns. This is Brad Griffin, another amazing member here at Mana. Another awesome trainer. But all being on the theme of Mother's Day coming up this Sunday. And no one knows the importance of Mother's Day more than the three of us. Now, what we're going to touch on now is through all the experience that we've had with all our female clients, we've sort of compiled a collective what women can do to optimize their overall health. There's a lot of intent, but because there's the lack of education behind that intent, they seem to be treading water and working really hard for very little reward. So we're going to give you guys a few tips and a few things that we've picked up along the way, and things that have worked for a lot of our clients. Results may vary, but we see a trend.
Appearance issues, body stigma. I think that sometimes is the impetus behind them, actually sort of making that initial step to come through the door, or start a fitness journey.
Most people are influenced majorly by social media.
Oh, definitely.
And what you see on there is what you perceive to be the standard or the norm at which you should be or you should perform, which is the biggest load of shit I've ever seen in my life. There's a huge difference, a great divide, a huge void between what is fitness and what is health. And what you see on social media 9 times out of 10 is not fitness, so do not buy into that. Everyone's on their own race, and it's not backed by science. It works for one person. They expect it to work for a million.
Yeah, and a lot of it's choreographed as well. Oh, and,
everything's edited.
Photoshopped and edited. Yeah. Just like this interview.
Yeah. Because we've said so much crap. That does not make sense.
He hasn't given me any media training. What's going on here? I need it.
We want this off the cuff because we want it to be real. We want it to be organic. We want it to be genuine. We want you guys to get the truth. So we're not going to script too much. We just want you guys to have what we feel and what we've experienced. So what you're getting is, 100%. What have you got to add to this, Ava?
Oh, well, what have I got to add? Okay, woman. Jesus. Time management.
Time management.
You need to make time for yourselves, okay?
That's a fact, ladies. That's a good one. Well, one of the excuses I have a lot is girls can't do the extracurricular training. They can't adhere to a nutrition program because they're time poor. We get it. You're a busy woman. You've got kids, you've got work, you've got relationships to maintain on top of maybe running your own business. The list goes on and on, and we understand that it really is a struggle, but we must. It's imperative for health. You have to make a small portion of time just for yourself on a daily basis, because we see a lot of women, don't we, mate, that are overworked, overstressed, and literally the secret to all that is good sleep and at least half an hour to yourself a day. And that can be in the form of
going out for a walk, having some fresh air, going to the beach,
reading a book.
Give me a massage.
Give me a message.
Sunlight also plays a massive factor on your health and your well-being. That conversion of vitamin D, you've got to get out in the sun for 10 minutes without sunscreen. That's a healthy dose of vitamin D, guys. Yeah, look around and get things at a distance and get things up nice and close. Test your peripheral vision, test your ocular range. So that is all good for mood enhancing and keeping the brain sharp.
We should touch bases on alcohol as well.
Yeah, that's
a big one.
We were discussing it just before this, prior to this filming.
It's Australian culture.
Absolutely
Australian culture. And it's not isolated at females.
But we're doing this for women. Yeah. So this is just, we're not
picking on you.
Yeah, exactly.
We're not picking on
you. It's not stereotypical. It's not stereotypical. The thing is, this is a touchy subject. Recovery takes 2 to 3 days, so you can't train, you're eating crap to try and feel better, and then you end up feeling worse about yourself and having to try and train it out. If we can give you any advice in that respect is either A, you make the right choices in that state of drunkenness, or cut back on your alcohol intake. And that's almost the answer. We're not saying don't drink, girls, because it'll be socially inept to say that you can't have a drink. You want to be able to have fun and enjoy yourself. Moderation is key, and being selective as to what you drink. And know your limits, you know where you stand. Don't get to the point where you can't function the next day. Your body is trying to process what it considers a poison, not a nutritional, beneficial food. So your body's so focused on what it needs to process first, your metabolism and everything else goes out the window. So think about that before you consume.
I think a lot of the time when we're drinking as well, it's just before we go to sleep.
You're not going to eat anything until you're finished tonight, because that eating is cheating, right?
Yeah.
And then what do you eat?
Yeah.
What's available? Yeah. We've got kebabs, pizzas, that's the only thing open in the bakery, 24 hours.
And then after that, sleeping patterns.
Yeah.
Sleeping patterns are out.
So you get 3 or 4 hours sleep, and then you wake up feeling like shit, cranky with the world.
Yeah.
You know, and what do you feel like? Ben & Jerry's. Yeah, because that's how I know I would. That puts us on to sleep.
Yes.
Sleep and its importance, because you need to get to the fifth REM cycle of sleep before you get any of that real good stuff that you do get from sleep. The neural flush that occurs, that sort of like wipes the slate clean every single day. Your immune system is boosted in that fifth cycle of sleep. If you're not getting to that point of unbroken sleep, you're only running on 50%. So those mums that are allowing their kids to dictate their breastfeeding patterns and staying up real late, watching something like television that gives them all that stimulus and doesn't allow the brain to settle and the nervous system to downregulate, that's gonna wreak havoc on you in terms of sleep patterns. Because sleep is probably the most beneficial form of recovery in terms of daily activity, training, stress management. Stress leads to sleeplessness, but sleeplessness also leads to stress. In order to get good sleep, you could be more active. So if you work at a desk all day long, you're going to want to move as frequently as possible, because that is your body's stagnant, and when it's in that sedentary position for long periods of time, there's not very many calories being burned, okay, and there's not much stimulus on the brain, so it's not being tested. Parking at the far end of the car park, which is going to happen to most of us in Byron Bay anyway, because we can't fucking get a car park. Park as far away as you can from the source of wherever you are, or shopping, walking that distance, okay? And then carrying the shopping bags back, that's activity. I mean, playing with your kids more frequently not only helps your health, but it also helps the relationships you have with your kids.
And helps your kids' health as well.
Yeah, exactly, which is another discussion. Yeah. When you do exercise frequently, hydration. So if you're not in an aqueous state and you're not getting the appropriate hydration, your cells are dying, literally dying. So that will definitely affect your sleep. Hydrating too late in the evening, up to the point where you go to sleep, will also keep you awake, because you have to urinate frequently in the middle of the night. So try and taper off about 3 to 4 hours before sleep, okay? But get plenty of water during the day. What do we do for exercise then? If exercise is gonna contribute to helping you sleep better and overall health, we need to start breaking a few bad habits and instilling a few good ones. That would come down to variability in your training. That's right on the cusp of all the science right now. That's the real buzzword. It may not be out there yet, but variability is definitely one that's coming. What do we mean by variability, boys?
Changing your mood, changing your exercises, not running every day. That's one thing.
So it's not necessarily. It's not necessarily running. We're not against running. Running's great. It's great
for ruining knees and ankles and having lower back problems.
But we
are joking. You know, it's very, very tiny shit.
Variating your training stimuluses and your stresses means that you're not doing the same thing that you do on a daily basis over and over and over and over again. Because what you're doing is putting the body through the same lines of stress repetitively. Sooner rather than later, there will be a break. There will be a leak in energy, there will be a fracture, there will be some sort of stress that warrants your body to break down. So what we want to happen is for you to select days, select training patterns, select movements that are out of the norm. Your DOMS, your delayed onset muscle soreness comes on day
two.
Okay? That's usually the height of your DOMS. So what you want to do is sort of allow yourself a 2 to 3 day window of recovery from a stress that you put it through before you do that same thing again. Okay? That's the rough guide, and that works for most people. So you want to have that in your mindset when you train. One day we're gonna do leg day, because every girl loves to do the legs. And then we can do a day of restorative stuff. You could do either some activation drills, some stretching, some yoga, some Pilates, okay? That gives the legs that time and that window to recover. The day after that, you could do a little bit of cardio to flush that lactic acid around to even improve the rate of recovery for your legs. So a light jog or a good walk up the lighthouse. And then you can go back to listening to a bit more stress on the legs or somewhere else in the body. Okay?
Every day is legs day. Yeah. Just like with men, every day is chest day.
Yeah. It's in our nature to do what we're good at and what we feel comfortable with.
What we enjoy.
Yeah. What you need to do is step outside of the circle that you're in, outside of the bubble, okay, and try something new and try and master it. That whole process of learning a skill and trying to attempt something different and getting the body to move within the parameters of that movement, that's where all the good stuff happens. That's where all the benefit of exercise is taken on by the body. That learning process is the good stuff. That's where your body changes for the better, which makes you more adaptable to life.
Doing the same thing over and over again becomes boring, doesn't it?
Oh, extremely.
Extremely.
It becomes boring. What happens when things become boring?
You can't stick to it. What we're trying to say is variability is a key factor in adherence and being able to stick to a routine. That keeps things fresh, it keeps your body learning, so your body can adapt to these different stresses. Just like life, you can adapt to all the stresses in life. It makes you life-proof. That is my saying to my clients. I want you to be life-proof. And that's why we put you through all these different modalities. It may look crazy to other people, it may sound weird to others, but adhering to variability principles will change your life. You will no longer break down, okay? Your mood stays more constant, your emotions stay more constant, and it's always on the plus side. You're always happier, you always feel
positive,
better.
Motivated.
And that comes back to that appearance. Yep. That comes back to the whole appearance issue, because your fitness should not be about how you look. That's a byproduct of the activity that you do.
It should be about your health.
It should be about health. Health trumps fitness any day of the week. So instead of going on gene size or comparativeness to anyone else and how they look and how slim they are, you worry about how you feel, how you're sleeping, how you treat other people, how you treat yourself. These are all the factors that you should be looking at in terms of judging whether you're in a fit, healthy state or not. And you're all amazing, and you need to look at inside as opposed to looking outside for gratification and justification of how you perform and how you look. It's a dead thing. It's old school, and let's not let it go any further with this, I guess, being your own worst critic and seeing all this shit on social media dictating how you behave and how you should look and how you feel inside. We see it all too often, and girls, you need to buy into that shit anymore, because anyone that's genuine can see you for who you are and how you feel, and that emulates through people how you feel inside. The reason why we're always so happy is because we're healthy. You know what I mean? And we've got each other's company.
Yeah.
Look, if you surround yourself around positivity, only positive shit can happen.
I'm pretty sure that's why everyone comes.
Yeah. Fact. And then take care of yourself first and foremost. Yes, your kids are everything to you. We get it. You know, we've been there in terms of our moms putting us first in front of themselves as well. And that's only going to lead you to an early grave. Looking after yourself gives you the ability to love and look after everyone else. Okay? So don't work yourself into the ground, girls. Take some time out to look after yourself. Feed yourself well. You don't have to eat what you feed your kids. And generally, you want to be feeding your kids what you eat anyway. Okay. Get some meditative time. time for reflection. I don't mean you have to do yoga or do the old moves, okay? Just take time to think about where you're going, where you've been. Some gratitude for the stuff that you've done for yourself, a bit of self-gratitude as well, because you girls are all quick to give gratitude to everyone else and give gratification to everybody else, which is, you know, what you girls are so good at. But you also need to give a bit of self-gratification
because of yourself.
Because if you can do that, then you're more inclined to look after yourself, and you're more inclined to perform better, and you're more inclined to be healthy. That comes back to prioritizing. So that recovery, that time management, that activity, the good sleep, that all comes down to priorities. It is really that simple.
It's really that simple. Goals helps to prioritize.
It all makes everything so hard, but if being healthy and being fit isn't a priority, then it'll never come to fruition. It'll never be in the mainstream. It'll never be in your spotlight. So if you don't make it a priority, then that's your prerogative and that's fine. But don't complain that you're not looking like this or feeling like this because it's your own fault.
I love you, Mum.
We all love you, Mum.
I love all the mothers out there.
We love mums. Yeah. Okay. Thank you so much for all the love that you give all of us, and thank you for supporting Mana.
Mana mums.
Happy Mother's Day.
And we hope this information helps. You know? And any questions, feel free to ask any of us.
Joe Robinson.
Yeah, you don't have to pay for it. It's free.